I vividly remember those wonderful days I spent at home, waking up to a beautiful morning in the garden and getting ready for school. Well, they call it a hostel, but to me, it was home. Oh yes, and by the way, I am a person with speech and hearing impairment. I believe my parents abandoned me in a railway compartment when they came to know that I could neither hear nor speak. A police inspector found me and brought me here. Yes, ours is a hidden disability which hinders our speech and language development, isolating us from the rest of the world. Here, our method of learning was different. A lot of emphasis was placed on language development. A multi-sensory approach was used. Our lovely teacher began the day by conversing with us. Some parents too sat by their children and helped them. That's when it struck me that I actually had no one to sit beside me. Finding me brooding alone, our darling principal, Latha ma'am, would often talk to me to make me feel at home. As days passed and I learned to express myself, the initial feeling of emptiness and loneliness slowly gave way into a deep sense of belonging. Our teachers did all they could to help me communicate. They got done tailor-made ear molds for fitting the hearing aids. I was then taught to lip read and speak. Gradually, I began to speak.
Li.
La.
Li.
La.
Ah. Papa.
We had experts come and conduct an audiometry test where they would give us a sound and we would respond. Slowly, I began to learn the language through visuals, reading and writing. I grew up into a confident teenager, quite at peace with myself. Until the lessons got tougher. I couldn't concentrate anymore. The days got lonely and I began to get frustrated. One day, my teacher could take it no more and reported about me to Latha ma'am. When I was asked what the problem was, I told her blatantly, "I am not interested in studying further." "So, what do you want to do?" she asked. "I can cook. I can make bags," I said enthusiastically. To my surprise, she gave in. Life became peaceful once again. I started cooking and baking for others. Evenings would be fun time in the hostel. I had many friends, some of whom studied very well. Years flew by. Before long, I was married in the same campus, which was my home for 2 decades. Today, I make a living selling homemade products. So what if I can't speak your language? A different language is a different vision of life.